Guangzhou, bitches!
So it's 6:40 and we are in the in a little cafe just after security check-in at Xi'an Airport, about to head towards Guangzhou. This little guy managed to make it through customs with me, which is good, because you know we couldn't leave Nick just going in the hold luggage. It's not right. We are so freaking tired. I think I've had about 3 hours sleep and just kind of fading in and out of consciousness. But it's good. This is going to be really, really exciting. Xi'an was amazing. And I'm really, really looking forward to seeing Guangzhou. I just really need this breakfast to arrive. And yeah, this will be the beginning of the next part of our journey. Hello. So we are just on the metro from Guangzhou Airport, Baiyun Airport, towards the East Railway Station. We're pretty shattered. The flight was pretty decent with a little bit of turbulence and a little vomiting kid, which is always fun. Alright, it's all generally fine. It's just been one of those things they're a little bit too used to in China, which is just the point and stare, which is happening quite a little bit in this place. We've just been saying that you know, normally, like, fair enough, kids point and stare, but often, instead of like turning the little kids off for it, adults join in. So it's a little bit less fun than it sounds. But it's good, it's exciting. We're soon going to be dumping all of our stuff off at the hostel, then heading to IKEA, which is going to be the best thing right now. It'll be really good fun. It's just really nice to feel like we've arrived in Guangzhou. The temperature is now about 15 degrees, which doesn't sound too hot, but if you're like me and you're British and you're used to about 5 at maximum at the moment in Weihai, it's pretty warm. So, I mean, it's nothing on what Vietnam's going to be by comparison, but this is starting to get a little bit warmer.
Svenska!
So, hi! We are finally arrived to Guangzhou, and luckily, like 1 or 2 minutes walk from the hostel, is IKEA! Are going to lunch here, and I feel almost like I'm almost home in Sweden right now. Yeah, so the hostel is basically in another family's home. I don't know how to explain. It feels like you're literally walking into a family's home, and there's like a bunch of beds everywhere. And we saw another Westerner. It was pretty awesome. Yeah, it feels a little bit strange, but I think it's gonna be good. And I mean, it's close to IKEA.
I'm a little bit worried, Caroline. There is a panda doing slightly naughty things to a little teddy over there. There are children here. What is the world coming to?
So hello. We are here in the little cafe in the IKEA in Guangzhou. It's really cool. Although a little bit tiny in many, many ways. They seem to pretty much, as long as you either have pasta, meatballs, or lasagna. Those are your options, and anything outside, woe betide. So yeah, it's pretty exciting. It feels very, very nice to be having this right now. I feel like we need it. Yeah, cool.
What are you having?
I am having the salmon lasagna with some, is it Grunsal? Grunsal, yeah. So yeah, can I see?
Nom.
Oh, it's gonna run at the now, so our plan right now is to go a little bit downtown in Guangzhou. We have a map that will guide us, hopefully. We've just been to IKEA to eat a wonderful, delicious dinner. And we bought some chocolate and lussebullar, a Swedish, like, cake, I don't know, ish, that we're gonna eat as fika later. But that's our plan.
Stay tuned, as Bob would say.
It's pretty good.
Lusabulla.
Yeah, this is pretty nice. It's kind of like a little cinnamony thing. It's pretty cool. It's still a little bit chilly from, it's not long been out of the freezer. Or fridge at least. This is really, really good. We're having a mini picnic fika thing in a sort of park or business plaza thing. And it's really nice. And it's so weird. Like, you know, it's January the 20th?
21st.
And here we are in like 15 degree temperatures having like a mini picnic. This is very, very foreign to me as a Brit. So this is very, very exciting indeed. And I've got some Swedish shit, so this is pretty good.
There's a McDonald's, Subway, Pizza Hut, KFC, and Starbucks around the corner.
Welcome to China! Woo, Chinese experience! I don't really understand.
It's a rotating ball of water.
I would like a mom. Medium. Bob Billy Ray, my new album's coming out next week. It's got some great songs on it, like My Mama Ate My Cat. Yeah, that's it, that's a new one. Yeah, check it out.
I remember when we broke up the first time, saying it was sin if I had enough, blah blah. Men are shit, why did they leave me?
Thank you, that was my new song. I'm Taylor Swift. Keep on buying my albums.
I remember when we broke up. First time seeing this is it, I've had enough. Cause like we haven't seen each other in a month.
So, we've been wandering a while trying to find the river. And I think we've ended up in the wrong country. Here we are next to the American consulate. So, you know, if we want to look at adoption or becoming American citizens, I guess this is our place. Yeah, pretty cool going. We are gonna become American. These people must be like, have these people never seen before? Hello, so here we are. We just come to the river that kind of separates parts of Guangzhou from each other. It's really, really cool so far. The city is massive, not only just in terms of size, like that way, but actually everything is so, so high. Everything is giant high-rises, giant skyscrapers. It's incredible, actually. It feels very, very much like London and kind of other really, really big business cities, but with a lot less of the commotion, actually. It's something that I'm a bit surprised about with this part of China. It seems a lot calmer at the moment than I was expecting. Maybe it's because everyone's at work at the moment, I don't know. Maybe it'll get crazy in about an hour or so when rush hour hits. But for the moment, it's really, really nice. So yeah, this is really, really cool. Behind us, we have a twisty tower thing. Apparently quite cool. I think this might be one of the big things from Guangzhou. We need to kind of investigate it a little bit further. But it's looking really, really cool so far. And then tomorrow, we're going to head out. We're going to look at some of the old Canton town, so the really old historical parts of Guangzhou, as well as some of the old British parts, I think, that where Britain used to have some kind of control over parts of this place. So should be really interesting, very, very odd. But so far, very much a city of, very much a city that doesn't really fit in some ways with what I thought it would look like. It's very, very different. And very nice, and actually a lot less polluted than I've been told to expect. Guangzhou is normally one of the places that's hitting the top, like, you know, 470 out of 500 for pollution kind of perfect. So, yeah, it's looking pretty cool so far, though.
Oh my god, that accidentally came out really, really well.
Papa.
It's 9:30.
This begins the second day in Guangzhou. We are just on the train at the moment, about to head towards the old Cantonese district. So we're going to go exploring, find loads of the really old side of Guangzhou. Like most of what we've seen so far has been like skyscrapers, businesses, really modern, giant buildings. And so it'll be quite exciting, I think, to see the old Guangzhou, like the Guangzhou that started, as in, you know, when it all started. So it should be pretty cool. It's going to be quite exciting. I'm looking forward to trying some of the local food as well, like the dim sum and some of the other like local things. So it should be pretty cool. Got my chocolate and I'll be ready for the day. So we good.
Is of course with us. We have been walking around this neighborhood and it looks so Chinese-ish compared to the modern China we saw yesterday. So stay tuned, it's Bob and Sam. Did you heard of even more?
So I just bought these little jellies. They look kind of incredible. I assume that they were little pastries and then this woman started scooping them out. But it's pretty cool. I don't really know what's in it. She was trying to describe it. One of them has like red beans, one of them's like a white, possibly lychee jelly. And if it is lychee, I will lose my head because I love lychees. Don't really know what that is. Kind of nice. It's not really sweet. And it's not really sour either. It's kind of just, yeah. I don't really know what that is, but it's pretty decent. are in a little Haagen-Dazs kind of cafe thing in Guangzhou. It's really cool. It's a nice, it's a really lovely day outside. We've been walking around, seeing some beautiful bits by the little river, seeing some really nice sights, like loads of people just chilling in a park on a Wednesday afternoon, kicking around those little things that look like shuttlecocks. And yeah, it's just been great. And it's really weird because from this set of journeys at least, this is our last full day in China. We leave Guangzhou tomorrow for Hanoi, and then we're in Vietnam. So it's very, very weird. Also, we've got a little flower, or some flowers. It looks a little bit romantic. So Caroline and I are going to have some sweet, loving times in this Haagen-Dazs place, obviously. It'll be great.
Man.
Real.
Oh, I can't even.
That's really good.
Yeah.
You know what one this was?
Benjamin Hanselman.
Sexual.
Sad Ali. I like the Sad Ali. Woo.
In it, though. Get out of my face! Get out my face! Can't stand this like paparazzi in here. I'm out.
Bob. Describe it again.
It's like nature and like architecture together. That's amazing. Fei Chang fashion. So, purely by accident, as we're walking around, we've kind of stumbled upon a little area called Shamien, which maybe isn't pronounced like that. It's like an old area that used to be controlled by Britain and France a while back, and only returned back to China in 1946. So, it's kind of odd. It's very, very Western in many ways. It's got the whole kind of sense of big gardens in the Western way of doing it, really, like very, very European. Yeah, it's kind of fun. I'm kind of quite intrigued to see all of the old buildings that are around here, because quite a few of them look very, very European in style, like European churches and administration buildings and all that kind of stuff. It's really cool. Yeah.
So we accidentally found this Christian church, which is really, really beautiful, in my opinion. And it is in this, yeah, British area here in Guangzhou. And I think I read just now that it's built in the 16th century by some Chinese emperor. I don't know his name, and I probably can't pronounce it. But it's really, really beautiful, and we're gonna go inside now.
Hey, door.